Welcome to A Moment with Meg. I am here with Cal Kehoe from Pink Talking Fish, the Cal Kehoe Band, and the newly formed Reprise Band. Cal, thank you so much for doing this.
Thank you for having me.
I'm going to get right into it because we only have a moment. So, Cal, you are just fresh off of just wildly successful shows at Nectar's with Reprise. You covered an 89 and a 94 fish show, two very different years of fish.
Oh, big time.
I'm really curious as to how you and the band prepared for these shows.
Oh, man. It was like we spent like 12 hours a day for 2 or 3 days straight, basically just rushing, not rushing through it, but really just meticulously trying to get the vibe of both of those years. While also being reminded that we're playing really complicated fish songs.
Yeah, exactly.
So we also had to get that too. So we had to get the songs under our belts and then also get the vibe like under our skin too. So.
Well, you did that.
Thank you.
You totally did that. And I'm so excited for this band and for this band to come to New York. And I hear it's on its way to a lot of cities.
Yeah, yeah. We're in talks to do a couple of pretty awesome shows. And yeah, honestly, I give it all to the team that's working on it. I mean, RJ and Tom and Austin and now some other friends, Ed and Matt. Everybody that's working on this is great. And honestly, I just have to give it up to the band too.
Like incredible band.
Chris, Adrian, and Scott, like they're really like the perfect guys to do it. So I really am very happy that we put this together.
Me too.
Yeah, it's great.
I'm so excited about it. You also are in the Cal Kehoe Band. You front the Cal Kehoe Band.
Yeah.
So I'd love to know what's going on with that and also any other projects you're working on.
Yeah, so Cal Kehoe Band, we have been recording a record in Brooklyn. Nice. We're actually in Brooklyn right now at the Brooklyn
Bowl. Oh, yeah, we're at the Brooklyn Bowl. I forgot to say that.
Pink Talking Fish is playing here tonight. We love playing here. But yeah, so we're recording a record in Brooklyn with a guy named Bryce Goggin, who he produced a lot of the and engineered a lot of the Pavement records in the 90s and
Amazing.
Has been working with Trey and Fish for a long time.
Wow.
And yeah, Tom Marshall kind of made that connection happen and we hit it off. And I think Bryce is coming to the show tonight.
Amazing.
He's a great dude. And yeah, we've recorded 7 songs so far. So hopefully we're going to release some tunes pretty soon. And then potentially a full album or EP either this summer or this fall. But yeah, Cal Kehoe Band is just playing. Right now we're playing once or twice a month right now.
That's great.
Because all of our schedules are so insane.
Yeah.
With Pink Talking Fish and all the other projects that everybody's in. But it's very special to me to finally get these like songs that we've been working on for so long out into the ether.
Yeah, that's so exciting. I can't wait to hear them.
Yeah.
Makes me wonder if there's an album that you were influenced by or inspired by when you were writing this album.
Oh, man. I think, honestly, there's this band called Real Estate.
I love Real Estate.
Yeah, they just put out that new record.
Daniel?
Yes.
So good.
And it made me want to get right back into the studio.
I love that.
I definitely had a playlist that I had in mind for a lot of the songs, but with the members of the band that I'm playing in, it's Miles Lavolsi on bass, Kieran Edwards on keys.
Incredible.
Henry Thomas on drums. They're all like Connecticut friends of mine pretty much, and they're incredible guys. When we get together, it's like we all have so many influences that like I think we're all stemming from different places. But like in my mind, I know what I want it to sound like.
Yeah.
And they just end up making it happen. So I don't know if I answered that question.
100%. That's so exciting. I cannot wait to hear it now. I love that album. It's been on repeat for me since it came out.
I've listened to it like 150 times in the last like 2 or 3 days.
That's such a great vibe. Such a great vibe. So we were talking before we started recording about that movies are back. For us, at least. It's been a great year for movies.
Yes.
So is there a movie you saw recently that you really loved?
So I've been thinking about this one a lot. Because I just recently got a Letterboxd account. Have you heard of Letterboxd?
Yes, I just joined it a few months ago.
Yeah, I just got Letterboxd.
Nice.
They do the Letterboxd question on red carpets. Like
yes.
Letterboxd, and they say, like, what are your 4 favorite movies?
Wait, will you be my friend on Letterboxd?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
I didn't know you could do that.
Yes, you can have friends.
It's like a social thing?
Yes, you can have friends on Letterboxd.
Sure, let's do it.
Okay.
I had no idea. So I'm going to answer in Letterboxd style.
Okay, love this.
Of only movies that came out last year.
Yes.
Poor Things.
Unbelievable.
Was incredible. I'm going to go back another year. Everything Everywhere All at Once.
Amazing.
I think is personally one of my favorite movies of all time. up there with like Eternal Sunshine of a Spotless Mind. Mm. I loved Oppenheimer.
Yeah.
And then it's like a, I'm going to throw Oppenheimer and Barbie in the same one. I'm going to do Barbenheimer because I love them both. My girlfriend and I did the Barbenheimer thing.
You did?
Yeah, we watched both in one day, the day it came
What
out.
Did you watch first?
Oh, Oppenheimer first.
Yeah, you got to do that.
You got to do the, you got to have the palate cleanser of Gosling and Margot Robbie.
Yeah.
Just like.
Making, it's your dessert.
It's the dessert, and it was just the perfect thing. The soundtrack is incredible. Like, I listen to I'm Just Ken all the time.
It's so good.
It's so good. And then my number one movie, I think, last year was The Holdovers with Paul Giamatti.
Amazing.
Incredible.
Yeah, such a great movie.
And yeah. The soundtrack are just amazing. It encapsulated 1971 really well. And I believe it is the only needle drop in a film of the Allman Brothers in memory of Elizabeth Reed.
Really?
I believe it is. Ooh. Which, when it came on, Tess and I were like, oh my God! Like, it was incredible. So.
That's amazing. Yeah, that movie is one of those, like, unlikely groups getting together and hitting it off, kind of that classic vibe. I loved it, too. Such a great film. What a great year for movies.
I know. It was really, really good. The Oscars were fantastic.
So much fun, right? Good vibes.
I'm a big movie guy.
Me too.
Really excited about Letterboxd.
Me too.
I've just rated, like, 500 movies out of boredom.
I know. I like to write little reviews, too. It's pretty fun.
Mm-hmm. See, that's what I'm afraid of that.
Don't be afraid.
Once I start, I've done a couple Google or Yelp reviews, and I don't want to do the letter.
Okay, but I'm glad you'll be my friend at least.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, great. I can't do the reviews.
Okay, great. Cal, this has been so much fun. Thank you so much for sitting down with me. I love talking to you.
Yeah.
You're an incredible talent, and you're also an unbelievably nice guy.
Thank you so much.
To call you my friend.
Likewise.
So, thank you so much, and thanks to everyone. We'll be back soon with some more of your favorite artists on A Moment with Meg.
Bye.
Bye, Kelly.
Bye. Thank you.